Okay. I need to be serious. Serious face. Okay. Okay, so my name is Bonnie Kissinger. I am a 500-hour registered yoga teacher, health coach, triathlon coach, mechanical engineer person. I started out this endeavor 210 pounds, couldn't run around the yard without feeling like I was going to die. I have severe hip issues, had a soccer scholarship, lost it because I couldn't walk upstairs. So I've gone through a lot of back issues, foot issues. So I wanted to show you some things that we can do, how your yoga practice can help with foot strength, running. If you want to be injury-free, working with your feet and leg strength is pretty important. So just everybody don't move. And then now look down at your feet. Look how you're standing. Okay, so a lot of our injuries don't stem from our running. A lot of our injuries stem from how we live in daily life. So if you're kind of standing like this and you have SI issues, okay, right? You know, kind of lazy, or you're sitting in your chair like this, okay? Or how you get out of your car, how your feet are, if you're wearing flip-flops all the time and you're a runner, those two things don't go together. Flip-flops actually make your feet work in a way that is not ever designed for your feet to work. So, you know, for the folks that I'm training, I suggest that once you get up high in mileage, you don't wear flip-flops. It's bad for your feet. It'll make your feet do funky things. So how we want to learn how to stand is that, like, our feet are hip distance apart, right? And that our ankles are kind of underneath of us. Nice and strong. In the yoga practice and classes, you'll hear a lot of get the outside of your feet parallel to the edge of the mat. And if I did that, I'd be standing like this because of how my feet are built. Okay. So for yoga classes that you go to, it's maybe more accurate to line yourself up with your ankle bone and your second toe. So lining yourself up anatomically like that is a little bit better. So learning how to stand like this, and then knees always slightly bent. Okay, so a lot of people, I can't do it, but a lot of people hyperextend their knees, and you want to learn how to have a slightly flexed knee, okay? So then we finish our beginning pose by lifting from right here, right? Okay, and then the hands kind of nice and soft. So take an idea of where your shoulders are at. Lower this one down. There you go. Your shoulders up there too. I know, right? You're like, okay. And then so lifting up here, but the shoulders kind of down, and try to habitually, if you can, let it go down a little bit. Okay. So this is mountain pose, and this is how we want to kind of stand all the time in life. Kind of sexy, isn't it? Okay. So notice that my toes are lifted. My toes are almost always usually kind of a little bit up, all right? And then when you lift your toes, you'll notice most of us will notice that our arches lift up a little bit, okay? So looking down at your feet, if your feet are kind of like this, then just know that you're in the tribe of flat feet, okay? I need to work on this a little bit. So we're going to try a balance pose that is nice and fun for the feet, and it's kind of a first step in developing stronger feet, stronger ankles. So it's to come up here and notice what your ankles do. They wobble out, right? Try to minimize that, okay? Hey, love, can you move over that way just a bit so you're not in the camera? A little bit more. And back. A little bit more. Right there. Awesome. Okay. So do you feel that that's kind of making this area right here cramp up a little bit? Okay. So learning how to balance up here and not let the ankles rock around and just being okay right here is very strengthening for the feet. Okay. And then shake the feet out a little bit. Okay. The next step of that, if you found that somewhat easy is to come up and then to do the squat and then back up. Try to stay on your toes. If you have problems with dorsiflexion is this in your feet, it'll be a little bit harder, right? And then you'll notice that this is really good knee strengthening too, because you want to keep the knees track straight forward, right? Not okay. Yeah, it's all right. You know what? My knees do that one time each yoga practice. Yeah. Good to go. Good. So you know how you notice how the ankles kind of are wobbling out a little bit? So the sides of the leg muscles, that's just weakness on one side. So yoga practice is really good at identifying where the weaknesses are at and then giving you the opportunity to fix it. That's the, you know, one leg, this leg, and then side to side. So that's awesome. Let's do a little bit of a warm-up. And so we raise up our hands. And then exhaling down, we're only going to halfway. So right here, notice that my knees are slightly bent. I'm sticking my sit bones out. Okay. And the next movement is to pull your heart forward. Should be ab work. And if you do it right, you'll feel the tension on your hamstrings tighten. Yes? Okay, this is all the hamstring stretch that you really need for right now. Okay, and then back up. And then exhaling, hands down to the heart. Namaste. Inhaling up. And then down, just halfway. Pulling the heart forward. You want to get your back flat. And then back up. And down. One more time. Up. And down, heart forward, yeah. And then back up and down. So a good yoga class in the beginning is gonna move the spine in the six different directions as a warm up. So just stand, try to get your feet where they need to be and then swing sideways. For those of you that have a stressful job, here is your opportunity to let your shoulders and your neck relax. So let the arms be heavy. Let the shoulder blades move around. If nobody has a stressful job, raise your hand. Okay, pause that. And then side to side. So lateral flexion in the spine. And this is a way that you could warm up nice and easy before you went running. Just that, those three movements. And then this one's nice if you add the arms in too, so they go up. So let's slow it down with the breath. So we're exhaling as we bend over, inhale up, and then exhale, and then inhale up, and exhale. And one more time to both sides. And then standing up. Go ahead and pause. So one of the things that yoga does is, the reason why it helps you sleep better at night is it helps you to put the body, the mind, the breath, and everything all together. So you just feel more one, a little bit, lets tension go and stuff like that. So in your yoga practice, when your teacher says move with your exhale and whatnot, that's what they're trying to do is put everything back together. We run through our lives like all over the place and things kind of become a little bit separate. Okay, so let's practice a standing pose. Let's go ahead and do warrior two. Everybody should be mostly familiar with this one. Let's practice with our right foot forward and the left foot steps back nice and long. Okay, so it's a long stance. The heel arch are in line with each other. Okay, if you have kind of funny hips or you know you need to change, your feet can be spread out a little bit, but we want them mostly in line. Before we add the hands, we want to go through this checklist. Toes lifted in the front. Okay. The knee most straightforward, trending this way. You should be using your glute on this one. Okay. the back foot. Here's where the foot strength comes in. Focus on the back edge of your foot and push it down. Exactly. Do you feel how that changed your foot? Got your arch lifted. So lift your back toes and still focus on that back edge of that foot. Your feet should be like saying, meh. Okay? See how your arch isn't coming up much yet? So change, shorten your stance a little bit. And now try it. Okay? So the Warrior Two is an open hip pelvic bowl neutral pose. So your pubic bone, your belly button, your heart, your nose should all be in line. So not forward. So tilt it. You got to kind of get it down on that back leg so everything is nice and neutral. Straight up. And then the arms lift up nice and soft. Hands are forward, reaching. Right. Okay. So if you wanted a little more work, bend more forward. There you go. Okay. Don't move yet. Watch. Stepping forward and try it. That is pelvic floor, a lot of core work to get that long step up. If you need to hop it up, but you want to kind of muster yourself up here, that's pelvic floor work. Let's try the other side. So the left foot, foot works. Engage that leg first before you move. It's strong, it's not moving around, and then I step back. Okay? Think of it as building a building. So the toes are lifted, right? The knee is working, my glute is working, that back foot, toes lifted, the outside of my foot's pressing down. So force your arch up a little bit more. Your feet are like, yeah, it's hard. Sometimes when your foot is not used to that, it's like, I can't get it to do it, okay? And then think about this, are you straight up? Warrior Two is where you're going to learn how to turn your traps off. True fact, you lift it up from the bottom, from down here, right? You feel that? And then you reach out. You're still reaching out with the bottom parts of your arm, the back part of your rotator cuff. Top should be soft, like they're floating on water. You're just like, no, they're not. Okay? And then watch. So I lift up. Try it. Good, long step. So we're gonna do Warrior Two a little bit different flavor. So the right foot forward, left foot steps back. Run through the checklist. The rules in Warrior Two are the front knee never comes past the ankle, so scoot your foot forward. It's weight bearing, so you don't want that knee past your ankle ever. Okay? And the knee is always out, never in. Never, ever, ever, ever in. Okay? Okay, no hands this time. We're working on feet today. So we're going to lift up the heel just a smidge. You're going to feel this is pelvic floor work and foot work and leg work. So you're going to just lift this up just a bit on the front. Okay? And then you're going to lift up the back just a bit. Mm-hmm. Yes, ma'am. Mm-hmm. But not quite. My heels are still just touching the mat. And when your feet go, that's enough. Step forward. So stretch the feet. What is that face for? Your feet? Yeah. Okay, try the other side. So it runs through the checklist. If you don't think about anything else in this pose, the front knee is it. Everything else can manage. Go ahead and straighten your back leg. Yep. And then use your glutes. Rotate that leg that way. The other way. That way. Okay. Now add the toes. Get off the heel in the front. Get off the heel in the back. See, you feel that engagement right there? Okay, go ahead and then step up. Shake, shake, shake. Stretch the feet. Okay, that's super awesome. So, moving to triangle pose, we're going to modify this a little bit because we don't have blocks. So it's the same foot stance. The right foot's forward, the left foot steps back, heel arch in line. This time the legs are going to stay mostly straight. Who knows they hyperextend their knees? Since you're being coached by me, I'm going to say this. You're going to break that habit. Okay? You want strong legs? You want a strong butt? Okay. So we want a... What'd you say? No? All right. Okay. So you want a strong leg. This leg, and I'm rotating it out a little bit. Think about that. Okay. Leg straight. The front one. There you go. Okay. So see your knee is kind of coming in this way a little bit. Bend it. And roll it out enough, the whole leg in the hip, that your heel wants to corkscrew. Do you feel? You feel that. I see it. You're working right here, isn't it? That's your glute and all kinds of stuff back here. Okay, the pelvic bowl tilts here. Tilts right here. So micro-bend your knee. It's going to be a hard habit, and I'm going to tell you each time until you get it. Okay? So we're moving in the triangle. I'm not putting a lot of weight on my leg. I'm just using it to roll open. The idea in triangle is that your rib cage, the inside of it, is going to line up with the ceiling, so in your hip, okay? Hands still on the hip, so your shoulder should be fairly open, okay? And then the next step of this kind of modified triangle is here. You want to try this? Bernie? Okay. Mirror, watch what she's doing, the person in front of you, okay? And then coming up, put your hands down, and then that long step forward again. Okay. So the other side, that step back, when you get there, you want it to where your leg's already there. This kinetic refiring of our hip. We want the glute to fire first before we go back. So think about it before you move back. Strong foot, strong leg. Glute working. And then tilt your pelvis. You should feel it in the hamstring and the inner thigh. Okay? And just a touch point here to roll the chest open. Nice and easy. And then the hand just kind of naturally goes up. Not with the ceiling, with where your heart's at. Okay? Okay, now watch what I do. I bring my hand down. I plant my back foot, and I'm pushing more on my back foot to help me come up. And then I step forward. Okay? And then side angle is a fun, nice stretch. The right foot's forward, and it's the same feet, that long step back. Okay? The knee bends. Make sure that your knee is trending that way. Good. Okay. Right here, I'm leaning forward. I haven't lost the contact with the back edge of my foot. So don't come so far forward. If you do, shorten your stance a little bit. You want to keep the back edge of your back foot down so you can still lift your arch. Okay? This contact point right here, I'm not resting. Is core work. You want a strong core? Yeah. Okay. So side angle, let's just keep it here. You know, it goes all kinds of places. So side angle, the first step is here. If you have shoulder issues, just stay here. The next step is you reach. Okay. And your hand should be facing behind you. There you go. More of that. So don't lose the back edge of that foot. Good. Should be a nice side stretch and an inner thigh stretch. Okay? Now listen before you move. I'm going to plant that back foot and I'm going to use that to come up and then step forward. It's hot in here. Okay. That's right. So on the opposite side, left foot. So here, come back up and I want to show you. Okay. Yoga has a really good way for the runners to retrain your hips, because a lot of times our glutes don't fire. They might be there, but they're actually not firing. And so you might be stepping back like this. Your yoga teacher says, you know, fix your knee, right? What we want to get to, and it'll improve your running, is if you're like, oh, all right, fire the glute. See, he's already trending where he needs to be. And then I go, and he's where he needs to be. So if you learn that habit, you'll learn how to refire things in a different sequence. You can learn that in your shoulders too, with your traps and your neck, if you do it right. Okay, so side angle here. Go through the checklist. Foot, knee. Your foot needs to come forward a little bit. Mm-hmm. Right. Okay, and then forward. Don't lose the back edge of that foot. You want to keep those toes lifted and that arch working. And then lift up. And then see my hand rotates. That's external rotation with that shoulder, good stuff, and then reaching forward. Okay, so you're thinking about connecting that middle finger with the back edge of your foot, the whole line. Try to find that whole line. Don't move. Look where your knees are at. Front knee. There's about half of you that let the knee cave in. Okay? Press that back foot down, come up, and then step forward. Okay. So we're going to go run through a sequence of those. Let me show you what it's going to look like. Just for some fun. Don't forget. Don't hound on all of it. We're going to be going through it too fast. Just the one thing, make sure the knee is strong. Everything else, don't worry about it. Okay, so we're going to step back, inhale up, exhale here, back to here, to here. Okay, yay, I'll lead you through it. It's awesome sauce. Okay, so stand at the top of your mat. Pretend you're the mat, draw them out. Okay, so stepping back. Warrior two, make sure the knee is strong. Inhale the hands up. Smile here for a second. And then as you exhale, straighten the front leg. Tilt the pelvis. Come to a little triangle. A breath here. Then come back up to warrior two. And then hand down, reaching forward. To side angle. Press the back edge of that foot down. Hand kind of cycles around and step up. So there's a little bit of hip strength there too, right? So top of the mat, left foot forward, step back. Warrior two on the opposite side. Inhale the hands up. You're fine. Just make sure that knee's where it needs to be. I do that stuff all the time. It doesn't matter. Just do the opposite side. Okay, and exhaling, straighten, tilt the pelvis, a little bit of a triangle. Okay, nice and strong, back to warrior two. Good, hand forward and reach for side angle. And then press that back edge of that foot down, bring your hand up, and then step forward. And then shake, 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 shake. Okay. So that's where you get a lot of hip strength running through those things, and then feet strength over time, being meticulous with some of the details. Okay? So we're going to go to, let's go to some closed hips. So open hip is when your knees are facing away from each other. Closed hip, ischial crests, everybody touch them. They're important to know anatomically. And then your knees and your toes face the same way. Okay? So we're going to do warrior one. So the leg stance is a little bit shorter. And a lot of people teach it different than what I'm going to. But for the runners, we're going to try to get the stretching in the back of the leg. So when your foot is out like this, the typical way that most people teach it, you don't get the stretch as if it's like this. Okay, because we want to find calf and soleus. So warrior one, the stance is a little bit shorter. It's a legs length, so try it. My feet are hip distance apart. My toes are mostly forward. Yeah. See how that changed the back calf? Mm-hmm. Out here, you lose 90% of it. And this is kind of how they do teach it. Warrior one and warrior two, and some yoga classes aren't that different. Okay? So if you have room to keep the back heel down, what I want you to do is think about that back foot and press the back heel down with the back side of your leg. Does everybody have it? You feel that action, it should start from here and go all the way down. And try to lift the back toes, it's kind of hard, right? It's a lot of work. Pyramid pose on the opposite side. Left foot forward, right foot steps back. That's what I did last time. See, I said it and did it opposite. Isn't that awesome? So pushing that back foot down, back heel down, right? Nice and strong here. Hips are forward, hip forward. A squeeze right here. Yeah. Okay, and then the hands up. And then reaching forward. Heart comes forward. Hip, 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 hip. Yep. As you come down, you're going to have to force that hip. Okay, and then back up and step forward. Okay, I'm going to show you a pyramid version that's really good for core strength and balance. The key is the inner thighs to not fall over. Okay, so this is what it looks like. I keep my hands on my hips. Adding the arms is a little bit hard on the back. If you don't have full command of back and abs, everything, I just suggest doing it this way. There's so many other ways to exercise everything else. Doing it this way is super stressful on the back. So I keep my hands here. What it's going to look like is I'm trying to keep my feet active. And you come down, it's going to be a heck of a nice hamstring stretch, right? And then up. So I exhale, and then inhale up. And try five of them. So line yourself up. The hips want to be straight forward first, okay? So key on the hips. And then exhaling down, lead with your heart. We want a flat back. You'll lead with the heart, and then inhale back up, exhale down. The key sometimes is pressing the back foot down, and it'll almost pull you up. Yeah, foot. More towards me. So do you feel how that like puts your whole core together from here kind of down to here, right? Yeah? Okay, try the other side. So when I'm coming up, when I'm down here, I press that back foot down and it kind of pulls me up, that whole backside core. So exhaling, hamstring, hip, and then back up. That hip tightness is getting in your way, isn't it?
Impossible.
I see it. This is one of my favorite strength moves. So if you wanted to kick it up a notch, those of you that go to the gym, you know the bar that you can do that with the that machine, you do that and I grab it and I'm either here, or if you wanted to be like that, that'd be really hard on the shoulders, and I just hold it here and then I do that with the weight and you add more here because you're pulling down with trans abs. Okay? Interesting activity. But so you're working core and you're getting a nice hamstring stretch along with it. Okay? All right. So we're going to move to some balance poses because when the feet and everything is equaled out, balance is fun. So tree pose is a really good exercise for feet. So we'll all try a little itty bitty one. The rule, I don't care what yoga class you go to, do not put your foot here. Okay, please. You're putting lateral pressure force this way on your knee, and it'd be like kicking it that way. Don't get into the habit of doing that. If you can't get your foot up here, be okay right here. It's all right, but never here because you put, okay? So here, I'm not going to add the hands yet. I want you to look down at your feet and you relax. Toes should be kind of relaxed and lifted. If you have that, drum your feet. You move your toes. Yeah. So the four corners of your feet are what you're wanting to balance with. If you're a runner that grips with your toes, you'll find this a little bit difficult. Okay? Good. So let's try the other side. So the core is kind of key here, where you lift up here, not falling down on there. But you need to allow your ankle to move and make the micro adjustments. Okay? Okay, let's switch legs and do the harder version. So up here. It was a hard truth that if you ever say your pants are getting in the way, it ain't the pants. Okay? Go ahead and try it. Good. Just snuggle up to that calf and be okay with it. Right. That's where, like, you're even touching the knee. Okay, try the other side. And they say that you should be able to get your foot up there without any assistance. Wow. I'm like, yeah, okay, whatever. Maybe if you're 20. Lift your toes. See how the balance kind of changes a little bit? Okay, one more thing. We're going to try tree pose again, and we're going to close our eyes. Okay, you can balance without your eyeballs. Your body has proprioception and it'll stand. So watch for a second while I'm going to talk you through the thought process. There's this mind muscle to learn how to be okay, uncomfortable, and breathe through the freak out movement. So here, what I'm doing is I'm staring at the floor. That's called a dursti, and I stare at it enough to where I'm not really looking at it anymore. And so you can have your hands here if you want. But you're calming yourself down, and then you close your eyes and notice how things kind of freak out a little bit. And if you can still breathe through it, things will mellow out a little bit. Try the little tree pose. Don't add the stress of the high one. And just try it for a second. There's this kind of moment of, if you can do it, moment of kind of like, oh, that's cool. Okay, give it a try. So did you find that moment where you could sort of breathe through the body going, and then find that little kind of, I'm sort of okay? I like that feeling. Let's try the other side. So stare at your spot, calm yourself down, and then when you're ready, close your eyes and try to breathe through it and let the ankle do its thing. It's a way to strengthen proprioception in your body and your balance. And kind of calm yourself down and focus. It's kind of a weird thing to practice. Okay, awesome. If everybody is okay with sitting on your knees on the floor, I wanted to show you something else that's kind of fun to do for your knees. But if you can't, see, mine do that all the time. If you can't sit like this, then just pause for a second. Anybody's knees bellowing? Right here? Kinda?
I can't.
Okay, you might wanna just pause for a second. Just go ahead and sit on the tush. Okay, so the movement, I'll do it twice so you can see both sides. It's gonna really stress the feet out and work the ankles and calves. So what it looks like is I sit back on my toes, and that might be fun too. And then pop up. It's a lot of core work. And I'm gonna try to get my heels down. This is still core work so you don't fall over. And then back down and down. So it looks like this. Inhale and exhale and then kick up. And then reach back. So that kick without falling over like that. And you want to try to minimize again how much the ankles are rolling out. So give it a try. Without coming up. I know, it's kind of fun. It's all core work. Don't hit the socks behind you. The socks behind you. Boink. See how, feel how much core work that is? Those are your transverse abs. And it stretches your feet. Feel how your ankles are kind of wobbling around a little bit when you're going back and forth? That's what you kind of want to try to minimize. Okay. Yes, both knees at the same time. Okay, awesome. Since we're down here, I wanted to show you, since we're all ladies, I was showing this group the other day, SI and IT band issues. I would start with this exercise. The transverse abs control where the hips are. The hips can move around like this. So they control that way. They provide support. They push the spine this way if they are working. So your back's not too lordotic. The hip flexors compensate so much for lower abs. Hip flexors compensate for lower abs. So we're gonna do these sit-ups like so, and the reason why we're doing that is the hip flexors can't work. Okay, watch first. Okay, so you're going to go down and you're going to control the fall, and you're not going to fall, and you're going to come back up. You're not going to jerk with your face or your hands. Okay, don't turn anything off as you go down. Don't rest when you get down, like right here. Okay, it's all right there. Give it a whirl. See, feel that point where everything goes bloop. you get lower, you're trans. I know, use your legs, girl. Yeah. So this is very low transverse abs. Good. So I've had 3 C-sections and a number of babies. This area can kind of become a mystery if it's numb or whatever, right? Like cut on it, stretched out. And your face, turn your face off. Okay, no, seriously. So the ways to help with this, if you can't do this activity, I would suggest that you get to the place where you can. It's a good way to fix your lower back issues, lower back pain. A step would be to have someone to hold your feet down or put your feet underneath a couch or do it in front of a doorknob and have something on there to pull. So if you're down here, you'll gain strength by controlling the down. And then, I don't know how you get up, just get up. Okay, eventually you'll be able to come back up. So 3 sets of 10. Oh, my abs are tired. I bet that sounded really good on the video too. Okay, so do 10 of them. Hey, that's awesome. Easy peasy. You almost got it. See how your legs are straightening? Uh-huh.
My hips.
Yeah. Grab your legs, girl.
Should you go all the way down?
Just the tips of my shoulder blades are touching. I don't go all the way down. Yeah, right there. Up, up, up. There you go. Feel them? Good. Sometimes they're there, they're strong enough that we're just not firing them. Because our hip flexors are there and they'll, you know, fight. You can do this all day long. Good deal. So do it again. This time, when you come up, press the bottom edge of your feet down. Do you feel how the kind of that whole bottom area, you can work that? Awesome sauce. 3 sets of 10. So part of the reason why we get IT band issues and SI issues, we stand wonky, blah, 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 blah. So the pelvic bowl, if you had babies, you know, those tear you up too, right? So the pelvic bowl is coming out and the IT band tries to snug stuff in because we have lost a good chunk of core strength or core functionality, firing or strength or both. And so the transverse abs are going to pull those together. Pelvic floor exercises, we've been talking about that too. Working on when you're stepping that long step up, that's all pelvic floor coming up and standing up. So if you're stronger in that core, your IT bands don't have to work to keep your hips together. Okay, awesome. Any questions? Okay, good deal. So let's just sit with our legs straight forward, and we're going to do a nice little stretch for a couple of minutes. Everybody okay on the floor? Okay. So, who's feeling hamstring right now? No? You want to get your bottom ribs and try to close the gap here. So, not rounding the back. My back is straight. I want all hamstring. I'm not trying to round my back. So, hamstring? Anybody feel a little bit in your hip? Kind of like right here?
Yeah.
Right? So easy on the chin. Okay, just turn all that off. Okay? So you want to always think about the heart forward, right? Pulling your ribs down and forward, those bottom edge of your ribs right here. You want to get those ribs on your thighs, right? Once your ribs are on your thighs, then you can round. Instead of being up here and going like that, which is really hard on the back. So here. So one more adjustment. Look at my feet and look at yours. Okay, four corners are mostly forward. And ideally, you would want them, the heels more forward. So, and then your calves, soleus. Uh-huh. Right. And if you can reach, it's kind of a nice feeling in the back. So you need to like lay off the stretch a little bit, come back up, right? Because your back's kind of like going rah. Yeah, so there. Be okay right there until your hamstrings become longer. Okay, good. So heart more forward, easier on here, right? Okay, and then coming up. Let's bring the right foot in. It doesn't matter where this foot goes. Okay, it doesn't matter. But it does matter that my hips are mostly forward. See, my hip bones are still forward. It's not this. Okay, because I want to get a back stretch too. So we're going to focus on hamstring on one leg. So again, we're trying to bring the rib down. So you might be here. Look at your foot, the strong foot, right? I like to reach with my opposite hand onto the other side. That feels nice on the shoulder. Okay, if you can reach your foot, there's a really nice shoulder stretch to be had. So I'm anchoring here too. And what I'm doing is I'm pushing, I'm turning this part of my hand on, everything else off. Okay, so I'm pushing here, and then I'm letting my foot pull my shoulder blade off the back. And then I'm rounding my back and get a really nice stretch in the shoulder blade. Does everybody feel that? Mm-hmm. Awesome stretch. Yeah?
As far as it goes.
You should Amazon longer hamstrings. Did everybody get their heart rate zones? And let's switch. So this would be head to knee pose, but really you want heart towards toe. Okay, you always want to lead with the heart. That'll help not stress the back out. So remember that the foot is active. If you're stretching like this habitually, you know what you're doing? You're missing one of your hamstrings. Okay, force the foot four corners forward and you'll get a different hamstring. And so once you've had enough leg, go ahead and move to the back where you anchor and you can push with the opposite hand and really pull that shoulder blade off the back. Yep. Isn't that a nice stretch? I love it. Mm-hmm. Okay, go ahead and come up. I'm going to show you one more stretch that I like, and it's good for IT band stuff. The only gotcha is if your knees are a little cranky. So this left foot needs to come in front of the right hip across the body. We're trying to take up space in the leg. You'll understand here in a second. So the foot's working. Ideally, you want to get the knees stacked up on top of each other, but the foot's not flat on the floor. He's just back, okay? So if your foot's working, and see how your foot likes to go like that, but you're missing a ham. Okay. So then if you're bringing your ribs down, you should feel here, ham IT. Okay. If you're working hard enough with your foot, it should cross that area that you're struggling with right here, right across the knee, that fascial area right here. It should feel not like muscular stretch, a little like, but not terribly bad. That's fascial stretching, which is a good thing. It gets tight because it's kind of irritated, right? So if you were to stay here a minute or two and then you got up, you'd be like, oh, wow, that's awesome. That's almost like a new leg. If your knee gets upset right here, you just put your wrist in, right? Okay. To kick it up a notch, crank that foot back, or you can try to push this away, and it'll bring it all the way down here. So if you wanted a little more out of this pose, you bring your head towards your knee, and it'll address all of your back, but be careful because it'll be intense. So here, so you feel that stretch come up your back almost all the way up to here. So get to a point where you can breathe through it. Does that come all the way up to the base right here?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Because we're putting all the pieces together. This is one of my favorite stretches to sit. It feels like naughty good, right? This is one of my favorite stretches to get all the way through my back. Okay, switch legs. So again, the steps are foot across the body. The foot's working, and it needs to be four corners out evenly. And then the foot over the top. The knees try to stack one on top of each other. Okay. One side might be different than the other, so just be okay with that. And then ribs come down. If you needed a strap, that would be okay. And then try to activate this outside of your foot enough to where you can bring the stretch from the hip all the way across the knee, all the way down. I know, right? It's a good stretch.
I didn't think it needed to stretch that much. Apparently
it does. Mm. It's a fascial.
Yeah.
This fascia that gets really tight. And so holding it this long, it gets past the muscles and into that fascia. And once you can get the fascia to stretch, then you can restructure everything. The fascia is just going to pull muscles back into where it wants.
Yeah.
Because that's what it does.
Right.
And so then adding the head. You know, and if you don't have enough stretch getting your head to your knee, take your head backwards more, so more here, if you want more stretch. That hip.
I feel it.
Okay, awesome. Okay, go ahead and release that. Okay. Awesome. So, questions? Thoughts? That's a lot of footwork. Your feet might be sore tomorrow. Okay? But it's a good practice, paying attention to your feet. Okay? Awesome.